There are many students at the University of Michigan who have purchased Canada Goose jackets. These jackets range anywhere from $650 to $1,100, and the average price of a coat in the US is about $50. So why is it that so many students have chosen this specific kind of luxury brand coat? Is it because it is actually the best in value? Or are there social factors that contribute to this purchase choice? And if so, what are those social factors, and how does it justify spending that amount of money on a winter coat, even if Michigan is as cold as it is? This is all to say that we are very intrigued by this coat choice and how it can represent different inequalities on campus. Why is it that people that have Canada Goose jackets typically spend time with people who also have Canada Goose jackets? And which divides occur in this very dominant thing, a red patch on the left shoulder that can be seen by anyone walking through the Michigan Diag and noticing that person clearly must have a lot of money to be able to buy perhaps an $800 coat. So we were trying to get to the bottom of these questions by talking to students, and our hypothesis was that indeed there is a social factor that contributes to this decision making, and that it does create a divide on campus. What we found is that yes, definitely there does exist a social factor that contributes to being able to justify buying a Canada Goose jacket, but our research wasn't conclusive enough to show whether or not there is a true divide, as people who do own Canada Goose jackets do sometimes interact with those who do not, and vice versa. The following five student interviews include students who both own and do not own Canada Goose jackets, and the types of questions that we ask them try to get to the bottom of how they made this decision and if they think that the coat really reflects $800 of value, or if they were more so driven by the status.
How did you go about choosing a winter coat?
I just needed something really warm because I know Michigan gets really cold. My friends who went to high school with me, who were like before me, I talked to them, and I like definitely get Canada Goose because you're gonna like freeze if you don't.
Are you from like a warmer area?
I'm from New York.
Okay, cool. Yeah. And do like a lot of your friends here have the same coat as you?
Yeah, most of them have Canada Goose.
What organizations are you in on campus?
I'm not in a frat. I'm in a couple of clubs. I'm in computer science. I'm in a couple of like computer clubs.
Do you like ever notice when people have the same coat as you? Or does it like not really matter?
Okay.
And do you feel like there are other jackets in the same like?
Is this specifically about Canada Goose?
This is specifically about coat choice,
okay.
But like understanding like how people make their choices. So like part of that is like Canada Goose, but part of it will also be for other people like why they chose their coat. Do you find that there are other jackets that you could have gotten that are equally as warm, or do you think
I wouldn't know. I doubt it though.
Yeah.
Because in New York I would be cold with other jackets, and here I'm not cold with this, so like it actually makes a difference.
So do you think that there's like a strong value?
Yeah.
To what you got.
Have a nice day.
In this interview, it was evident that the interviewee was aware of a potential Canada Goose stereotype that might exist. This interview showed that the interviewee was mostly driven to buy his Canada Goose jackets by friends back home in New York who told him Michigan was going to be very cold. This jacket received the stamp of approval from the people in his circles that he trusted. And this interviewee is just one example of many that shows how important the social factors and purchasing decisions are, even if it's such a great decision as buying an $800 coat versus buying a $50 or $100 winter coat. It is also interesting to note that at some point in the interviewer said, "Most of my friends have Canada Goose jackets." That shows that not only was he advised to buy one of these coats before coming to college, but once he came to college, he looked to people who also had the same purchase choice as potential friends and was able to create social groups that either he influenced into buying Canada Goose jackets or felt more comfortable with because they were able to have this connection in common. When asked which organizations he is a part of, the student said that he was not in a fraternity, as though there is a stigma linking Greek life on campus to Canada Goose jackets. There are relations that students make between having wealth and being able to afford being in Greek life, which could cost up to $2,000 per year just to be a part of this organization. It's also interesting to note that without even having really tried other coats, this interviewee stated that he doesn't know if other coats would be better, but he doubts it because Canada Goose is the best, which also insinuates that there is a link that buyers perhaps make between item price and item value. And perhaps since Canada Goose jackets are in the higher tier and the more luxury brand of coats, buyers might believe that they are therefore superior to other coats.
Where are you from?
I'm from Boston.
And Boston's obviously super cold.
It is.
Yeah, so
it's cold here though.
What kind of winter coat did you have before you came to Michigan? Did you have the same coat that you were currently wearing?
No. Okay. I got this right before I came.
Right before you came. So did you buy it in anticipation of coming here? Like, it's gonna be really cold in Michigan?
Yeah.
And had you seen a lot of like Canada Goose jackets in Boston before?
I'd seen some. I knew I wanted one. I thought they were like good quality jackets. They were fashionable. They would keep me warm. So
yeah,
I thought it'd be like a nice gift, I guess, for my parents going into school.
And do your friends have the same clothes as you?
Some of them do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What kind of coat did you have before?
I kind of switched it up. Like,
yeah.
Sometimes I wore like Patagonia, sometimes I wore my swim jacket, sometimes I wore like a nicer jacket, really depended.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And do you think that like for the value you're getting, like all those things, it's fashionable, it's really warm, maybe the price that was justified?
Honestly, I love it so much. I don't regret buying it. I think it's amazing.
Yeah.
It's honestly saved my day a lot, so.
So warm.
I feel grateful that I was able to get one, I guess.
In this interview, a Boston native who had seen Canada Goose jackets in her hometown, different from the other interviewees shown thus far, decided to buy this coat, as she states, as a gift from her parents to her for graduating from high school before attending the University of Michigan. When deciding to buy a coat, this interviewee did not consider budget constraints in her parameters. As she stated, fashion, comfort, and warmth were the three highest priorities. Although she understands the privileges associated with owning such a coat, she does state that she wouldn't trade the coat for anything and believes that she's gotten full utility out of the jacket, in stating that it even has saved her day many a time.
Well, I came from Seoul, and
yeah.
Seoul is very cold.
It is?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like minus 20 degrees Celsius. I don't know if it's fair enough.
Yeah. Did you own a winter jacket in Seoul?
Yeah.
And did you own this winter jacket in Seoul?
No, I bought this in Michigan.
Gotcha.
I don't remember the name of the jacket I got in Seoul, but...
So what was the decision-making process behind buying the coat that you currently wear?
Walking around and, like, felt freezing. It's not only cold in Michigan, but it's kind of windy.
Yeah.
So that made me want to buy something windproof.
Mm-hmm.
And I looked up the coat on the internet, and then a lot of people said about the Canada Goose.
Yeah.
And they said it's windproof, and like also it's snowy in Michigan.
Yeah, exactly.
So, that, and then
mm-hmm.
it can I can wear this up to like minus 30 degrees Celsius.
Yeah.
So that's one of the...
So you like asked around and were like, what's the best coat
for
this temperature?
On the internet and then with my friends.
Do a lot of your friends at Michigan have the same coat as you?
Yeah.
Do you find that there are other coats that you probably could have gotten that fit the bill, or was it kind of just like, I want the best, so let me just go?
I just want the best because I am staying here for about like 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
I bought this like 2 years ago.
In this interview, the interviewee came from Seoul, South Korea, and Seoul is a very cold place, as he states in his interview, but still he bought his Canada Goose jacket as a sophomore at the University of Michigan. His freshman year, he noticed that other people were wearing this jacket and had looked it up online and asked friends about the jacket and then made the purchase choice. He also stated that many of his friends also owned the same type of coat. That international students typically come from more wealthy families, and therefore he can likely afford a jacket of that caliber. In addition, he has most of his friends own the same coat, which indicates some amount of social pressure. What's interesting as well is that when asked about his previous jacket, he couldn't remember the name, but without being prompted, he was able to recall the name of his Canada Goose jacket, showing that brand recognition is indeed a part of the buyer's thought process when purchasing a Canada Goose jacket.
How did you decide to buy the coat you're wearing?
It was relatively budget friendly and it looked nice and I could get it delivered to my house.
If you don't mind me asking, what does budget friendly mean?
This coat was about $120.
Okay, fair. And what about you?
So I actually bought this coat before I came to Michigan. So like I didn't realize that every single person at Michigan had a Canada Goose. I bought it because I heard it was like a warm jacket.
Yeah.
And like I don't personally think it looks very nice. I'm from like Philadelphia area. Okay. So it's like a little warmer, but not too much warmer.
And so what was the coat that you had before this one?
Just like a North Face jacket.
Gotcha. And do like, I mean, Nivetha doesn't, but do a lot of your other friends have Canada Goose jackets on campus?
I think like maybe like 1/5 of them do.
Yeah.
Probably about.
Fair. And you grew up, Nivetha, in Ann Arbor.
Yeah.
Coats like yours, what do you notice more of before you came here, and like what do you notice more like now that you're at Michigan?
I guess in high school everyone just wore North Faces or like just simple jackets, but then in college everyone had parkas, and then all of the East Coast kids all came with like the Canada Goose jackets.
Did you see people that you went to high school with that came here that then bought Canada Goose jackets?
No, I don't think so. The people that I went to high school with think they're overrated.
This interview showed the contrast between two individuals who knew each other who didn't own the same type of jacket. The woman on the right owned a $100 coat, a brand she didn't even know off the top of her head, and the man on the left owned a Canada Goose jacket. He came from the Philadelphia area, not a particularly warm place, and upon finding out that he was coming to the University of Michigan, purchased a Canada Goose jacket because of the expected cold temperature. The girl on the right grew up in Ann Arbor, Michigan, and never saw a need to purchase such a coat, and most of her high school friends that then came here from a pretty affluent high school also did not make the purchase even upon attending the University of Michigan. What's interesting is that the woman on the right also commented on how most students from the Northeast who come to the University of Michigan are known to purchase Canada Goose jackets, and that there is somewhat of an association between coming from out of state, coming from richer areas such as New York, Connecticut, etc., and purchasing a more expensive brand name coat. It's the contrast between the two individuals. One more so relied on recommendations prior to coming to the University of Michigan, and the other person was more budget conscious because they're from this area and perhaps understand how to deal with the temperature in Michigan. However, what was most clear is that the priorities of these two buyers were very different, and they were also at varying levels of consciousness about the brands that they were representing.
Are you cold?
I don't get cold except for my ears. So I'm somewhat cold because I'm not wearing my earmuffs.
Winter jacket that you have?
Correct.
And have you had it since before college? Because you grew up in the Northeast, right?
Correct. I grew up in New Jersey. No, I got this winter coat actually, I believe, my first semester of sophomore year.
What were you using before that?
Own a winter coat.
Oh, you didn't have a coat at all?
My first year on campus, I did not own a winter coat. That was the year we had the cold day and the first day off in 38 years at the school.
Why is it that you haven't bought a different winter jacket? Are you just because you don't get cold?
This is awesome. This is fantastic. It was cheap.
Do you mind if I...
Absolutely. It was cheap. It's a Carhartt jacket. I think Carhartt is one of the finest brands in the business. I like it. It keeps me warm and it looks good. It was reasonably priced.
What does that mean, reasonably priced?
I got it for about $50 on Amazon.
Do a lot of your friends own similar jackets to you?
No, not a lot of them. I don't know if I'd say statistically significant, but a fair number of them own Canada Goose jackets. Some of them own other winter coats as well, such as North Face, such as Patagonia. But I don't believe anyone owns a Carhartt.
In our final interview, the interviewee showed off his $50 Carhartt coat, made in Detroit and one of a kind. What was interesting is that he was very aware of the fact that other students did own Canada Goose jackets, even mentioning that a few of his friends owned these jackets as well. This interviewee valued price over fashion and over warmth or comfort, stating that he didn't even own a winter coat the first full year of college, one of the coldest winters in Michigan's recent history. All in all, here's what we found. Students typically who can afford Canada Goose jackets from our research tend to have made those decisions based on recommendations from other friends. The second thing that we learned is that those who own Canada Goose jackets are very well aware of the negative and positive implications that the red patch on their left arm has. That is to say that students are well aware of the stigmas that are associated with owning a Canada Goose jacket and choose to, as we've seen in our interviews, ignore the negative stereotype and spend time with people who also own Canada Goose jackets, presumably to stay in their in-group. And here's how this relates to what we've been learning in class. Many Americans reject the idea of American inequality. This is because they want to preserve this ideal of the American dream. The point of preserving the ideal of the American dream is to believe in a meritocracy, and part of owning a Canada Goose jacket, typically when parents are the ones footing the bill, is that it directly contradicts the American dream, because these students, in most cases, haven't worked for their jackets that are the average price of rent in Ann Arbor. In addition, most students at the University of Michigan do come from pretty wealthy backgrounds. A recent New York Times article showed that a large portion of 1%ers send their children to the University of Michigan. In addition, the average family income at the university is $154,000 a year, which is about 3 times the national average. And these families probably can't afford to give their children Canada Goose jackets. And what we've known from class is that these students are then taught to reject notions of inequality and have avoided the topic altogether in every interview that we've conducted. We hope that this has been informative, and we urge you to send us any questions you might have. Some things that we are still curious about: why are these students avoiding questions of costliness? Another question that we're curious about is, are there sacrifices being made, maybe in the price of rent, maybe in joining different student organizations? Perhaps students are cooking more than they're eating out to be able to afford a Canada Goose jacket. Are there cases in which status is more important than living within one's means? We hope to continue our research and find out soon enough. Thank you so much for watching.